Today's Dilmah Tea Party is brought to you by Dilmah Earl Grey Tea. G'day, welcome to the Dilmah Tea Party for the first day of this Wellington Test match, 192 for 7 New Zealand, batting first. Great fight back in that session from Sri Lanka. I'm sure they'll look to do more of the same after tea. Time now to introduce my Dilmah Tea Party guest for today, former New Zealand cricketer, New Zealand keeper, ND stalwart, Robbie Hart. Robbie, thanks for coming on the Dilmah Tea Party with me.
Doully, thanks for having me. Great
pour
to be here.
Pour you a cup of tea. Now, we've got you on. You've got a capacity of many things at the moment. You're obviously a very good lawyer. You've got your own firm in Hamilton with a few others, but you've come up with this very interesting bat grip.
Yes.
2mmsports, Robbie, this is the main thing I want to come and talk to you about. We've got a couple of kids' examples here, but tell us, what is it? Why? Wow. Where, how did you come up with the idea?
Well, it started about 5 years ago.
Yeah.
Friends of mine, Dave Richardson, who's a sports cricket coach, mm-hmm. and his son Bones, wanted to solve a problem that coaches have always struggled with.
Yep.
So they did a lot of work in the first 2 or 3 years just getting through to the first prototype. And it's as simple as with the top hand, so this is the adult's one.
Yep.
With the top hand, there's some ridges at the top, so when you hold the bat there,
mm-hmm.
You stay on the ball for longer. So it almost right. pushes your front shoulder and your elbow through the ball.
Mm-hmm.
So for someone like me that hits through backwards square leg,
yes, yes, yeah.
you actually want to stay on the ball longer and hit, okay. through, hit it straight or hit through mid-on.
Does that mean I wouldn't have hit so many over cow corner or what?
Yeah, you would have probably hit it down through mid-off.
Okay, good, good. And the bottom hand?
With the bottom hand, there's some ridges along here, so when you put your hand on the bat,
mm-hmm.
It's a bit like the Adam Gilchrist with the squash ball.
Right.
You've just got much better contact on the bat,
okay.
and it's a lot harder to choke it.
Right.
So you just have nice, soft contact on the bat, and then you can hinge through the ball. So as you lift the bat up, you hinge.
I picked this bat up here. And straight away, it felt really good. I couldn't believe
absolutely.
How comfortable it felt, how good the hands just felt. They just sort of wrapped around it.
Absolutely.
You know yourself, I play a lot of golf now, and there's yep. a very similar golfing tool that is brilliant.
Yes.
And it just wraps your hands, it puts your hands in exactly the right place. So that's the concept, isn't it? But kids, adults, so who's using it at the moment?
So it's a mixture of kids and adults at the moment.
Yep.
We've got the adults using the blue grip,
mm-hmm.
and we've been through 7 or 8 prototypes in the process to get
just
to one
to get it right, yeah.
that we're happy to go to market with.
Yeah.
So this is the adults using this one. The kids here, I'll use it on a bat. This is
yep.
my daughter Lucy uses this one. This
okay,
is,
good.
This is green. So the kids have a choice of green,
yep.
or if I get Ned's bat.
Ned, okay.
We've got orange.
He's got the orange one. He's
yep.
got a plastic one.
Yep.
He's not quite as big yet, is he?
No,
Ned?
Not quite
okay.
as big yet. So that's orange for the
yep.
choice of the two. The beauty of it is, at the very basic level, it gets your hands in the right place.
Yeah.
So you've got your hands on there, it's uncomfortable to hold the bat incorrectly.
Mm.
But for the more advanced level, for guys like you, Doull, that used to like your cover drives
used
and everything else, for the more advanced level, it's about just those little small shifts that just make it feel more comfortable,
yep.
make you feel like you want to hit the ball in the right direction.
Have you played a game using it?
I
had a hit in the nets
I've had a truckload of hits in the last 2 or 3 years because
yep.
I didn't want to get involved with it until I was really happy that it worked.
I was going to say, because you know, you're quite meticulous about how you go about everything.
Absolutely.
You wouldn't want to be involved unless you thought it was perfect or absolutely spot on.
No, absolutely. And the beauty of it is we've got a very good friend in Daniel Vittori who's,
yep.
Whose judgment I trust a lot, and mm-hmm. he's tried it and liked it. And
so
he's
making it for left-handers as well, that's one thing.
Left-handers as well, yep.
All right.
So Dan is the face of the grip.
Yep.
So if you go to the website, you might see me at the back of it somewhere, but you'll see Dan as the face of the grip, and people can associate a player of Dan's ability
yep.
with using the
There's
grip.
There's the website, www.2mmsports.com. So jump on there, you can find out a lot more about it. Now, are we allowed to use it? At club level, at international level, what's the rules around it, whether it's allowed to be used or not?
We are. That was our biggest business risk,
yep.
and we've just got past that about 3 weeks ago. We've had it approved by the powers that be,
mm-hmm.
so it's now you can use it as a training aid, but more importantly, you can take it into competitive cricket. You can play a test match out here at the base, and you could use it out here.
Seriously?
So, yep.
So club cricketers, are they
yep.
starting to get involved with using it? I mean, are you involved with any clubs in Hamilton that are using it, guys that you know?
We're slowly getting it out there. Guys like
yep.
Shannon Stewart in the South Island are using it
mm-hmm.
and getting really good feedback on it.
Fantastic.
And guys like, obviously, Dan in the North
yep.
Island are using it.
So you've got some good quality cricketers involved in it. They've tried it, I suppose, in the nets. Now, going back to the company itself, how... interesting was that for you to get into that involvement? I mean, I know you've been on the New Zealand Cricket Board. Yeah, what about setting up a company, all these things? I mean, that must have been a bit of a risk.
It's great being in business with close friends like Bones and Dave, that I really trust their judgment and we work well together. So it's just the three of us. We've got obviously different shareholdings and we work together as a group, and I might do some of the commercial and legal stuff, and Dave and Bones will do a lot of the marketing and the hands-on designing the prototypes and getting stuff together. So we're a good group, the three of us.
Where's it being made, Robbie?
It's been made in Whanganui by a company called Axiom.
So you're New Zealand made as well, which is also really good.
And we had the moulds to actually produce the grip. The moulds were made in China.
Yep.
And that was a big part of it, getting that through the system during the winter.
I look at these and I think it is quite solid. Is it difficult to get on the bat itself? And how have you got about being able to get it on the bat? Is it glued on? It clearly can't be rolled on that easily.
No. So it's really simple to get on. It gets pushed straight on the bat. Mm-hmm. So you put it on the bat like this. You push it down with some PVA glue.
Right.
More as a lubricant than anything, just to slide it on. And if you put it in hot water firsthand, it expands a little bit, so it's easy to put on.
And gets quite soft, and it just slides down nice and easily, and then
it's really
just glued on.
Yep, it's all good.
Fantastic. All right, well, more with Robbie Hart very shortly about this great new grip, 2mmsports.com if you want the website. Time for today's Out and About with Craig Cumming.
Well, thanks, Dolly. Well, it's been a very special day today here in, well, the Wellington City at the Basin Reserve, and I'm joined by the Wellington Mayor, Celia Wade-Brown. Well, good afternoon, Celia. Thank you for joining me.
Good afternoon. It's a lovely day at the Basin.
A superb day and a very special day because something pretty unique's happened today. You've presented a key to the Wellington City to a player or a cricketer who's not actually from the Wellington City.
Well, Captain Brendan McCullum, I should say, has done such an awesome job. That triple century back in February 2014, we felt really deserved a symbolic gesture on the part of the city.
All around the world it was shown, great pictures of the Basin. How important is that for you to get some profile, I suppose, when it comes to a player doing that for the city?
Well, Wellington always wants the worldwide profile we can get. The last keys to the city were given to Sir Richard and Sir Peter, and again, Brendan's putting Wellington on the map with his great achievement in the Basin Reserve.
You've got to be careful. I'm from Dunedin. We're not going to steal him away from Dunedin, though.
Oh, he'd be very welcome.
What does it mean also to get the key to the city? What does that mean? What does it allow Brendan to do when he turns up in Wellington?
Well, he's just very, 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 very welcome to Wellington, to the capital. I think the Basin Reserve is a spiritual home of cricket in New Zealand, and this is just a recognition of his contribution. So it won't let him off his parking fines, it won't let him off his rates, but it's a real symbolic gesture on behalf of all Wellingtonians to Brendan.
Tell us a little bit about the Basin Reserve, because there's a lot of talk about the development with the ground. Can you tell us what's in the pipeline in the near future?
We're looking at our long-term plan, like councils are all around the country, and we're looking to a bit of refurbishment. The cricket museum's here, it's pretty important history. We hope the key will end up in the cricket museum as well. And, you know, there need to be some improvements to the facilities for players over the next few years. We will keep the atmosphere of the Basin, the beautiful banks and the Pūtikawas. It's a pretty special place.
Yeah, it certainly is. And is it like anywhere? It's tough these days to find, I suppose, extra funding to come available to help, regenerate sort of sporting facilities in the city?
Wellington City Council has invested a lot in sporting facilities, whether it's the artificial turfs for football and rugby, or whether it's the Basin Reserve, and of course the Westpac Stadium as well. So we're pretty keen on sport in Wellington.
Well, I know that Christchurch think they've got a hold of the Boxing Day Test, but today's a fantastic atmosphere here at the Basin Reserve. You always want to be known as the number one cricket ground in the country.
We are the number one cricket ground, and a little bit of imitation is the sincerest form of flattery.
Well, one of the greatest things, you've given away a key today. One thing I'd love to give to you is we've got a little voucher here from Dilmah, so a $50 voucher, so hopefully you can sit back and relax, enjoy some Dilmah, and thank you very much for joining us.
I love my cup of tea. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks very much, Craig. Your chance to win with the Dilmah Tea Party. We've got 12 single region selection packs to be won. Dilmah.co.nz/teaparty. You can enter the draw there and be in to win one of those 12 packs. Right, still with Robbie Hart. Not long to go now. He's come up with this great concept, the ultimate bat grip. I think it's a very, very good name for it, Rob. The Rock, now that's the kids one, isn't it?
The Rock. That's the kids one.
Yep. Premium packaging too. It's really done well. And the Pure. That's for the adults?
That's for the adults. And well done, Hanson's in Cambridge that did the design of the packaging.
They designed everything. See, it's not very local, mate. Wanganui, the grip's being made and everything else being done in New Zealand too. Just very quickly, Robbie, I know you're an ND stalwart, mate.
I am.
How proud are you of the ND boys that are performing well? Tim Southey, Trent Bolt, Kane Williamson, doing a great job for New Zealand at the moment.
Absolutely. Great seeing guys coming through like they are. And a big thing with ND was we were about winning games and making a difference. Mm. And you're seeing guys scoring big hundreds and guys taking bags of wickets, so that's really good to see.
Outstanding, Robbie. All right, mate. Good luck with the grip. I think it's fantastic. As I say, you pick that up, it just fits into the hand wonderfully well. Good luck with that, with the sales of the grip, and I hope over the years we get kids involved in it. They'll learn how to hold the bat properly, which is something that I probably didn't do enough of. Some Tina take back to Hamilton with you. I know you've got a road trip with you.